stopped in traffic and asleep at the wheel. That's how police found an Albuquerque firefighter.
They say he was drunk more than twice the legal limit. Good evening. I'm Shelley Rubando.
And I'm Doug Fernandez. That firefighter is facing an aggravated DWI charge, and he's speaking only to Action 7 News anchor Natalie Swaby.
The veteran firefighter works for the Albuquerque Fire Department out of this downtown law enforcement building. He's in records management, but the future of his career is uncertain. He tells me what he did is inexcusable.
A veteran firefighter arrested for DWI, and the man behind this mugshot agreed to speak with Action 7 News.
I made a grave error in judgment, and it's not about defending the undefendable.
Umar Dinengrat's been with the Albuquerque Fire Department for more than 36 years, but early Saturday morning he was arrested here at Montgomery and Wantabo. His truck was stopped in a traffic lane, and according to a criminal complaint, he was asleep at the wheel, his car keys in the console.
I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed for the people I serve. I'm embarrassed for this great department I've had the opportunity to work on. I'm embarrassed for my family.
That same day, AFD learned about the arrest that happened here, but it wasn't until Monday that Human Resources discovered the DWI arrest is not the firefighter's first.
I had one over 8 years ago.
That's something that I'm going to be looking into, too. I just don't know why there's nothing in the file.
Deputy Chief Craig Sadbury says Dinengrat told him about the old DWI and Saturday's arrest. Now it's all under investigation. And it's just the latest firefighter investigation this year. Lawrence Baca was terminated after his DWI. Michael Quinones was suspended after he faced charges for assaulting an officer. Raymond Sanchez's aggravated battery charge also got him suspended. And Fire Lieutenant Dominic Otero was demoted after being charged with driving drunk with his two kids in the car. As for Dinengrat,
it's a matter of making choices. And
he says he knows he made the wrong one and is waiting to see what the consequences will be.
The firefighter is on administrative leave, but under a new policy, that means he'll still be clocking in, likely doing clerical work while this matter's under investigation. Live in downtown Albuquerque, Natalie Swaby, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The deputy chief we spoke with says anytime one of AFD's firefighters gets into trouble, it's disappointing. He says it hurts the department's image, and the investigations that follow are something AFD takes very seriously.